Yes.
Today we have been discussing first chapter in mathematics paper 2A, complex numbers. So the weightage marks in the IPE 2+2+4, totally 8 marks. Okay. Today we are discussing about this topic, complex numbers. First of all, the definition of a complex number is, a complex number is an ordered pair of real numbers. Ordered pair of real numbers. What is the definition of complex numbers? A complex number is an ordered pair of real numbers. Okay, so ordered pair A comma B, and the set of all complex numbers, the set of all complex numbers is denoted by capital C letter, capital C. Okay, so capital C is equals to the set of ordered pair A comma B such that small a belongs to capital R, small b belongs to capital. Okay, so this is the set form of the complex number. Next, the standard form of the complex number is a plus ib. What is the standard form? A plus ib. Here small a is called real part. This is called real part, small a. And next, ib is called imaginary part. Okay, what is the question? What is the standard form of the complex number? A plus ib, where small a is called real part and ib is called imaginary part. Okay, next, in this complex numbers we have to learn some properties. So first of all, how to add two complex numbers? Addition of two complex numbers. Okay, so let us consider. Suppose we are making, if z1 is equals to ordered pair A comma B and z2 is equals to ordered pair C comma D, then z1 plus z2, that means the addition of two complex numbers. So first of all, z1 is equal to ordered pair A comma B and z2 is equal to ordered pair C comma D. Here I am adding two complex numbers. Now z1 plus z2 is equal to, write out the complex form is A plus ib, and plus the complex form of z2 is C plus id. Okay, how to add two complex numbers? Adding real part to real part and imaginary part to imaginary part. That is the concept of addition of two complex numbers. Okay, how to add real part to real part? That means A plus C. Okay, and plus I is the common. Next, B plus D. Okay, so the order form of this one is A plus C, order pair, and the writer B plus D. Okay, this is the concept of addition of two complex numbers. Next, negative of a complex numbers. I'm taking another complex number. Okay, so if z is equals to, I'm taking A plus ib is the complex number, then negative of a complex number is denoted by minus z. So minus z is equals to, okay, minus a minus ib. Okay, its ordered pair form is minus a comma minus b. This one is called negative of a complex numbers. Okay, right. Next, third point. Okay, first one is addition over negative over. Next multiplication of two complex numbers. Okay, so we are taking two complex numbers. If z1 is equals to order pair a comma b and z2 is equals to order pair c comma d, then the multiplication of two complex numbers z1 into z2 is equals to, I wrote its complex form. Its complex form is a plus ib into. Next, second order pair complex form is c plus id. Okay, how to multiplication? First form, a into c is equals to ac. Next plus a into id, a id. Okay, next plus ib into c is equals to ibc. Okay, next plus ib into id is equals to I square bd. Okay, all of you observe here, I square, according to Euler mathematician, the I square value is equal to so much minus 1. Okay, so therefore from the AC, then I square value is equal to so much minus 1. So write here minus 1, then this becomes minus BD. Okay, plus I did that I is the common, you will get AD plus BC. Okay, next, its order pair form is AC minus BD comma next AD plus BC. This is the concept of multiplication of two complex numbers. Okay, next. Our next concept is division. Division of two complex numbers. Okay, have a day. First, if z1 is equals to order pair a comma b and z2 is equals to order pair c comma d, so then z1 by z2 is nothing but a division of two complex numbers. So z1 by z2 is equals to, or I write its complex form, a plus ib is divided by z2 is equals to c plus id. Next, what is the rationalizing factor of denominator c minus id? So that's why you have to multiply divided with the c minus id. So c minus id divided by c minus id. Multiply and divide. Next is simplification. Okay, a into c is equals to ac. Next, minus a into id minus aid. Next plus ib into c is equals to ibc. So plus into minus is equals to minus. I into I is equals to I square. B into D is equals to BD. 4-1. All of you observe here. In denominator, I have C plus ID into C minus ID. Now it is in the form of A plus B into A minus B formula. We know that A plus B into A minus B formula is A square minus B square. Okay? So now it becomes C into C, C square minus of I into I, I square, B into D is equals to B. Next, in this section, B into D is equals to B square. Okay? Next, according to Euler mathematician, I square value is equal to so much? Minus 1. Okay? So therefore, AC, I square value is equal to minus 1. Minus 2 minus 3 becomes plus. So plus BD. Okay? Next, if you're taking plus I is the common, you will get BC minus AD 4 by, again, I square value is equals to minus 1. So therefore, you will get C square plus D square. Next, I don't know its order pair form. Its order pair form is equals to AC plus BD, okay, by, so C square plus D square comma. Next one is BC minus AD whole by, so C square plus D square. So this is the concept of division of two complex numbers. Okay, next. Okay, next we have to discuss about the conjugate of a complex number. Okay, let us consider if z is equals to, can I make one complex number? So x plus I y. Okay, so then its conjugate. So its conjugate is denoted by. So conjugate is denoted by. So z bar. How to denote the conjugate? Z bar. Okay. So where z bar is equals to the conjugate of x plus I y is x minus I y. X minus I y. Okay. For example, for understanding purpose, I am taking one example. If z is equals to one complex number is 2 plus 3i, then find the conjugate. Then find the conjugate of this complex number. How to denote the complex number? How to denote the conjugate? Z bar. Z bar is equals to, okay? So 2 minus 3i. 2 minus 3i is called the conjugate of the given complex number. Next part. Modulus of a complex number. Complex number. Okay? Steps. Suppose that here I am considering if z is equals to, okay now? Suppose a plus ib. Okay? If z is equals to a plus ib, then the modulus can be denoted as modulus of z is equals to under root of a square plus b square. This is called a modulus of a complex number. Okay. Next point we have to discuss it about multiplicative inverse of a complex number. Multiplicative inverse of a complex number. Okay. For example, let us consider if z is equals, we are making complex number a plus ib. Okay. Now we have to find the multiplicative inverse of complex number a plus ib. Okay. Its multiplication, multiplicative inverse is 1 by a plus ib. What is the rationalizing factor of denominator a minus ib? So therefore, multiplying and dividing with a minus ib is equals to, okay. So a minus ib is divided by. So now again it is in the form of a plus b into a minus b. So therefore a into a is equals to a square and plus into minus is equals to minus, I into I is equals to I square, b into b is equals to b square. According to Euler mathematician, I square value is equals to how much? Minus 1. So therefore we get a minus ib is divided by. So a square plus b square. Alright, on its ordered pair form is a by a square plus b square comma minus b by a square plus b square. Okay, this is the concept of multiplicative inverse of a complex number. Okay. Understanding purpose, help making an example. Okay, find multiplicative inverse. Multiplicative inverse of a complex number. Complex number 2 plus 3a. 2 plus 3a. Okay? Right. Comparing this complex number with the general form of the a plus b. Okay? So, what is the formula for multiplicative inverse of a complex number? A by a square plus b square, comma minus b by a square plus b square. Here small a value is equal to so much amount 2 and small b value is equal to 3. Our multiplication formula is a by a square plus b square comma minus b by a square plus b square. Okay. Next substitution. Put a value is equal to 2 and b value is equal to 3. So therefore it is become 2 by x to 2 square is equals to 4 plus b value is equals to 3. So 3 square is equals to 9. Next, minus b is divided by a square, 4 plus 9. Okay. So therefore, finally we get the answer is 2 by 9 plus 4 is equals to 13 and minus 3 divided by 9 plus 4 is equals to 13. So therefore, it is the multiplicative inverse of a 2 plus 3 pi. Okay. Right. Next. Conclusion. Okay. Okay. So next. Next one is most important. It is given in March 2020. Okay, for 2 months. So the problem is, if z is equals to ordered wave cos theta comma sin theta, okay, then find z minus 1 by z. Z minus 1 by z. It is given in March 2020 for 2 months. Okay. How to solve this one? See. So first of all, here given z is equals to cos theta comma sin theta. Or I know it's a complex form. Z is equals to complex form is cos theta plus I sin theta. Okay. Next, it's a reciprocal. So reciprocal of z is 1 by z. So therefore, the reciprocal of cos theta plus I sin theta is cos theta minus I sin theta. Okay. Next, we are asking find z minus 1 by z.
Yes.
So therefore, now z minus 1 by z and is equals to substituting z is equals to cos theta plus I sin theta. Next, minus of, so 1 by z value is equals to cos theta minus I sin theta. Okay. Next, the simplification of this one. Cos theta plus I sin theta minus cos theta minus b minus it becomes plus I sin theta. Okay. Here cos theta cancel. I sin theta is equals to 2 I sin theta. Okay. So therefore, then I'm getting, so cos theta cancel means real part is equals to 0. So therefore, I sin theta is equals to 2 I sin theta. Okay. So therefore, the value of z minus 1 by z is equals to how much? 0 comma 2 I sin theta. Okay. So our items on K form is 0 comma 2 sin theta. Okay. Next. Next one is find the multiplicative inverse of ordered pair cos theta comma sin theta. Ordered pair cos theta comma sin theta. Okay, right. So already we have the multiplicative inverse of inverse of a complex number, a plus ib is, formula is order pair a by a square plus b square comma minus b by a square plus b square is the formula. Okay, so according to our problem, here small a value is equals to cos theta and b value is equals to sin theta. Okay, apply here. So therefore, the multiplicative inverse is cos theta is divided by, so cos square theta plus sin square theta. Next, minus b value is equals to sin theta. So minus sin theta is divided by, so cos square theta and plus sin square theta. According to trigonometry, sin square, you know that sin square theta plus cos square theta is equals to how much? 1. Okay. So that's why the denominator part value is equal to how much? 1. It is becomes 1. So therefore, the final answer is cos theta comma minus sin theta. So this is the multiplicative inverse of cos theta comma sin theta. Okay.
say this is a block.
Okay,
dear students, so today's homework is exercise 1A. Okay, solve first 5 minutes. Okay, all of you solve this 5 minutes.